So let's switch between an Atmi to cell types. So you see it is now switching easily, and now we have four perturbations from the all genes, and now we can again choose and select our threshold. And if you want to save this, welcome to another video tutorial. In this video, I will show you how we can use this Gene Investigator tool for Windows to perform a comparison of these two data set. As you see, in the first data set, we have a list of genes causing cancer in human beings, and then we have a list of genes for programmed cell death in human being. So we will use these two lists in this Gene Investigator, and we will try to explore hierarchical clustering and co-expression, etc. So as you see here, we have single experiment tools, then we have compendium wide analysis, then we have gene search tools, and then we have similarity search tool. So first we need to select our database which will run on the background of this website. So this software is you can download from Gene Investigator website, and as you see, this is actually the data selection. So first we need to select our data. As you see, we have to select our organism. So we will select, because we are working on human beings, so we will select Homo sapiens. And as you see, we have different platform, and as you see, messenger RNA sequencing, gene level Homo sapiens, reference ensemble 97. This is used as defaults, and it has a lot of genes. So if you want to go with few genes, so of course you can also try this Affymetrix human genome. So it will help you to generate, I mean, less crowded results. But for the time being, maybe we can use this one. And we can also try the different filters, like we can try on the base of anatomy, then cell lines and new plasm and unspecified organs. So just to, because as you see, the samples selected are too many. So for simplicity, I will just unselect this. And we can name this selection, maybe we can just write video, and we will select only okay. So as you see, now it is automatically retrieving the data from the servers on the back end, and now we will upload our these list of genes into this under this selection. So let's wait for a while until this retrieving data from server is ended. You see here, now our data is selected on the back end. So now we can go with our gene selection. So as here, we need to select the organism, then we need to create a new gene selection. So we can go here, we can simply copy these cancer genes. And if you want to just make a separation, we can use this double line. I mean, we have 21 IDs from this cancer data, and we have another from BCD. And you see, now we have a total of 48. So we will simply click on this OK. So it will start to retrieve the data of these 48 genes from the database we have selected. And as you see, it is showing an error that this could only identify the data of 36 genes we have entered, but it's okay for the time being. Maybe we can use this one. So you see now it is downloading the experiment data for these 36 genes from that database which we have selected. And now we can perform our single experiment tool, like this we have as a samples. So you see here, we have just top 10 selected genes for this sample differential expression. So as you see, if we see the first gene, that is CHEK2, And as here you see, we have the different we have scatter plot, and we have the different cell anatomy in the different human tissues. So we can also change it to the heat plot of all these genes by simply switching this option. So you see here, now we have expression of all these 36 gene and their average significance in all the tissues. So we can also go to the differential expression, but it will take some time. So let me go back and use this for hierarchical clustering. So we will simply click on this hierarchical clustering. You see, now we have hierarchical clustering and anatomy based on the anatomy. So you see, again we have 36 genes from this Homo sapiens, and here you see on the basis of anatomy, like in the umbilical, fetus, brain, I mean the expression of this. So if you want to save this figure for your result purpose, and maybe you can go to this one and you can simply save, and you can select the download option, and from here you can scale your image, and maybe we can go with original size. If you want to increase, you can use this scale, but let's go with the original size, and let me save it in the form of PDF. So here you go. You see, it is now writing our file, and we can go back and check this hierarchical clustering. Yeah, you see here, now we have hierarchical clustering of all those 36 genes in the different anatomy tissues. And now we can go back to this Gene Investigator tool, and if you want to change it based on the cell types, perturbation, cell lines, cancer, or others. So let's switch between anatomy to cell types. So you see, it is now switching easily. And now we have for perturbations, we can go back to the anatomy and we can go to the co-expression. So let's suppose if you want to have a look on the co-expression. So first you need to go and you need to select only one gene whose expression is similar, and you want to see any gene. Let me find it, anyone here, maybe this gene, and if we want to check its co-expression, so we can simply go to add and we can select this one gene and click OK. So you see, we have only selected one gene, and now we can go with this one, and we can have a click, we can click on this run. So you see, now we have a data set of 321 anatomical parts from data selection, which we have just decided based on the video. Here you see that gene which we have actually selected. You see EGFR from the selection. So if you see, if we will increase this correlation, I mean, so you see, whenever we are increasing the correlation, so it is now decreasing the number of co-express network. So let's suppose we can select based on the like 0.5 connected genes with mutual correlation. At least if we see that we have 0.5. So you see, there are many which are difficult to interpret. So you can decide, I mean, your threshold, and you can have at least showing 25 genes which are most correlated with the expression of this gene figure. So again, you can save this image, and maybe in the form of PDF file. And you see here, we have our co-expression network of that specific one gene. I mean, and as you see, we have also a list of 25 genes from this database whose expression pattern is similar to this gene. So in this way, Gene Investigator can be helpful to perform hierarchical clustering, and as well as it will help you to get the list of those genes which have similar co-expression network than your candidate gene. So hopefully this software will be helpful in determining further gene to disease association network. If you have still any question, please let me know in the comments section. Thank you for watching. Bye bye.